Appearing for the F2 visa interview, in this video, I'm going to be talking about all the possible set of questions that you can be asked and how to answer them. Keep on watching. Hi guys, my name is Shachi and I'm a travel and a visa coach. On this channel, you will find lots of useful videos on the US visa process, so make sure to check them out. So of late, I've been getting a lot of DMs, emails and messages from those of you who are appearing for your F2 visa interview in the next 2 months. And in this video, I'm going to be covering how exactly you need to prepare for this interview. So let's get started. So let's just quickly start with what exactly is an F2 visa. So F2 visa is the dependent visa of F1, which means that if your spouse is going to the US on the F1 visa, then you can accompany him or her on an F2 visa. And for the F2 visa interview, you can either give it with your spouse. So when your spouse goes for their F1, you can accompany them and give your interview, or you can give the F2 visa independently once your spouse's F1 visa is approved. So in this video, I'm going to be covering the interview questions for both the scenarios. Let's get into it. So the questions that can be asked to you for the F2 interview can be divided into three different categories, and I'll be going through each of these categories and explaining you the possible set of questions. So the first category that we have is background and profile. So background and profile are all the questions which are related to yours and your spouse's background. So this includes education background as well as your work profile. So the interview can start with a very basic question such as, what do you do? Or what's your background? Or tell me about yourself. And here the interviewer or the visa officer mainly wants to know about your education and your work background. So you can quickly summarize that to him in 2 to 3 lines. And if you're working, then you can expect more follow-up questions regarding your job, the designation, the salary, the profile, how many years you have worked, how many companies you have changed. You can even be asked about what will happen to your job or your career in India if you go to US on the F2 visa. Apart from the job, questions can also be asked to you about your education background, about the degrees that you have completed, what was your CGPA, and so on. The next set of questions on a background and profile are those related to your marriage. So you can be expected to be asked basic questions about your wedding and about the marriage, such as when did the wedding take place, what was the date, what kind of ceremony it was, whether it was an arranged marriage or otherwise. You can also be asked how long you know each other, whether you were dating before the wedding happened, and so on. It's also a good idea to carry with you certain photographs, you know, which shows proof of the relationship and also shows proof of the wedding ceremony. The third set of questions that can be asked to you are those related to your spouse. And this is especially more important if you are appearing for the F2 visa alone. So here you could be asked questions about what your spouse is doing in the US. If he or she is studying, then you can be asked which is the university he or she is studying in, what is the program, how many years are left for the program. If they are working on OPD period, then you can also be asked where do they work, what is their salary, what is their designation, and so on. So essentially, basic set of questions that any spouse would know can be asked to you under profile and background section. Before we move into the next category, a pro tip here. So if you're going to be applying alone for the F2 visa, you can also be asked, why are you applying alone? Why did you not apply with your spouse? So here you'll have to figure out why the timelines did not match. Maybe when your spouse was applying, you were still working and you know you needed some time to wrap up your work, put in your papers, or you wanted your spouse to first go to the US, settle down for, you know, maybe a few months or a year, and then join him or her. So whatever is your situation, keep an answer ready for this if you're going to be applying alone for the F2 visa. The next category that we're going to be covering is about your stay in the US. So these are the set of questions that are going to be asked to understand what exactly you plan to do in the US. Now, you would know that if you're on the F2 visa, you cannot work, but you can enroll for some education courses, you can enroll in universities. So first, one of the questions that can be asked to you is, what do you plan to do in the US? So here, it's good to have a rough plan chalked out. It's not necessary that you need to have an admission from a university or you need to already have enrolled for some courses, but it's just good to have a rough idea about your plan in the US. So if you're planning to enroll for some course, you can say that you have these courses in mind and you will explore these options once you get there. If not, you're planning to just take a break, you know, just take a sabbatical from work or just completely take a clean break, then you can tell the same to the visa officer as well. But do think about the number of years that you plan to stay in the US and also what is it that you intend to do during this period. The second question about plan in the US can be about your expenses. So you can be asked, how do you plan to manage the total expenses as a family in the US? So here, having adequate funding, right? Showing that you have enough liquidity, you have backing of your sponsor would be important. So when your spouse goes for the F1 interview, they would have prepared their financial documents and their funding. You need to be doing the same when you go for your F2 interview as well. Third question in this category could be about your accommodation. So you could be asked, where is it that you plan to stay? What kind of housing or what kind of accommodation are you planning to take up? You could also be asked if your spouse has already rented or already arranged for such an accommodation. And the last and the final question under this category are questions related to other dependents. So along with you, if your children are planning to join you, then questions can also be asked about them, that what is it that they plan to do, which are the schools they plan to enroll in. So again, it's a good idea to have certain basic research ready. So whichever is the locality or the area that you plan to stay, do a little bit of research on the possible set of school options and education options for your dependent children. Before we move to the next category, a pro tip here. So here, what you need to be really mindful about is the timeline when you are applying. So if you're applying too close to a period when the F1 visa of your spouse is going to expire, then you can be asked as to why you're applying now, right? So be very mindful of when within that F1 visa period you apply for your F2 visa. It's a good idea not to apply too late to the expiry date of F1, because this is a question that generally gets raised, saying that, you know, if their F1 visa is nearing the expiry period, then what is the point of you joining them now? And the third category of question is about the future plans. So these questions are essentially aimed to understand your ties to home country and what is it that you plan to do once your stay in the US is over. So you have to show strong ties to home country and you have to show intention that both of you will come back to India. So to prepare for this, you need to highlight the job opportunities that you have and your spouse has. So if you were previously working, you can talk about how you will go back to work. Or if you're not working, you can basically focus on your spouse's job opportunities and say that once their program is over, there are plenty of opportunities in India in his or her domain, and that is the reason why you will come back. A pro tip here is to sync the timelines, right? So make sure that whatever is the timeline that you are indicating for your plan in US matches exactly with that of your spouse. Because if you're going to be come back, it's more believable that both of you, that is the husband and wife, will come back together. So make sure that the timelines of your plans are matched, which means that the period in which he or she is finishing the education is also the period in which you will wrap up whatever if you're doing any course or any other program in the US, so that when you plan to come back, both of you will come back together. So these are the three category of questions that you need to be prepared for your F2 visa interview. Of course, the exact set of questions will depend upon your profile, your background, and what your spouse is doing in the US. So if you want a more in-depth preparation, feel free to book a one-to-one consultation session with me. This will be done on a video call, and I'll be helping you structure and prepare your answers as per your profile for the visa interview. If you just want practice, confidence building, and somebody to just proofread or proof check everything that you have prepared, then you can also book a mock interview session. This will be very close to the actual visa interview, and this is a great way to build confidence and just feel thoroughly prepared for the main day. Before I end, I also want to highlight the document checklist for F2 visa. So a lot of you have asked me for this checklist. So here are the critical or the most important documents that you need to have with you. First one is an updated I-20. So you need to have an updated I-20 in which the dependent's expense is clearly mentioned. Second is, of course, your passport, your DS-160. Be very careful when you fill your DS-160 form. A lot of people I see fill it at the last minute, fill it, you know, very casually, but errors in the DS-160 form is also a reason why visas get rejected. So be extremely thorough when filling your DS-160 form, especially on questions which are related to who is sponsoring your trip and about your work and education details. Next are the financial documents. So like I mentioned earlier, just like the F1 visa interview, you also need to show that you have enough financial strength, you have enough liquidity to support your stay in the US. So for this, you need to carry the financial documents with you. Basically, it's the financial documents of your sponsor. And this is similar to what your spouse would have showed in the interview, but the liquidity has to be enough as per the updated I-20 amount. And the last set of critical documents are all the marriage-related documents. So your marriage certificate, all the photographs, any other supporting evidence is also something which is often asked, so be prepared for this as well. And in the end, remember that it's an interview, so how you perform on the day, right, how you perform in front of the visa officer is the most critical part. So prepare well for this, get enough practice, build your confidence, also dress well, dress appropriately, because these are small things which, you know, add up and, you know, can contribute to a visa acceptance or denial. And like I said, for a more in-depth prep, feel free to get in touch with me. If there are more specific topics about F2 visa interview that you would like me to cover, feel free to leave them in the comment section below. You can also DM me on Instagram. My Instagram handle is at shachi.mal. Alright, thank you so much for watching. I hope this has been helpful. Signing off for now. I'll see you in the next one. Bye.